Hey everyone, welcome to our first December BFX episode of the year. And since it's getting ridiculously cold, we thought we'd show you how to build a rig that you can pretty much only use outside. This week we're not showing you how to make any fancy makeup or gore effects, but instead showing you how to build a cable cam rig. It's basically like a dolly in the air, gliding along on a cable or a rope instead of a track. This unique filmmaking tool lets you get some really cool angles, like over the head shots, long tracking shots, and crazy fly-throughs. But before we get started, we've got to determine our budget. Whoa. Tank of number 8 clothesline, 3 clothesline pulleys, a set of 2 ratchet straps, a handful of 5/16 bolts, wing nuts, and washers, 4 5/16 by 2 inch eye bolts, 2 flat mending plates, 1 8 foot 2x3, and a chunk of scrap 3/4 inch plywood.
This week on WePC TV.
How have computers changed the recording industry and your job?
The fact that people can make records on their own is huge. It's definitely opened up the possibilities.
WePC TV is brought to you by ASUS and Intel. You dream it, ASUS builds it, Intel inside it.
The first step is to cut 2 18-inch lengths using 2x3s. Place them in a T shape and nail on a staple plate to each side. Then attach the clothesline pulleys to each end of this T shape. Make sure and pre-drill your holes so your wood doesn't split. Also, make sure not to over-tighten the mounting screws to the pulleys, otherwise you'll break the plastic. Now grab a scrap piece of plywood that's at least 17 inches long and 2.5 inches wide. Cut out 1 3-inch length and 2 7-inch lengths. Then cut a 7-inch chunk from the 2x3. Now we're going to build the top rotating piece that hangs off the T section. With the 3-inch piece on top, attach the 2 7-inch pieces like so. Then screw on a scrap of 2x3 to the lower section. This basically acts as an extender, but you need the open space in the middle to get the bolt inside. Now we're ready to start building the tilting camera box. First, we need to know how much room your camera needs. Open the LCD and place the camera on another scrap of 2.5-inch wide plywood. Add an extra inch to each side and cut to this length. Next, measure the length of your camera. Take half of that and add 2 inches. We're gonna use this length to cut 2 pieces that will become the top sides of our box. The lower side pieces should be about 2/3 the height of your camera. Now, using carriage bolts, wing nuts, and washers, you can bolt the lower and upper side pieces together. Use some more scrap wood to finish up this square and you've got a tilting camera box. Next, set your camera inside the box with the LCD open. Mark on the wood where your tripod mount needs to go and drill a 1/4-inch hole. A long 1/4-inch bolt, washer, and wing nut will act as your camera mount. Now you can attach the camera box to the rotating hanger piece. Then, the whole assembly can be bolted to the T piece. The last thing to build is our rope mounts. Just take a 22-inch long piece of scrap wood and mount 2 eye bolts 18 inches apart. We need to build 2 of these. Now grab all these parts, some rope, ratchet straps, and your camera, and you're ready to go on location. Once you get outside, find 2 trees that are 40 feet apart or less. Use your ratchet straps to attach one of the rope mounts to a tree. Put the rope through your dolly and tie it to this fixed mount. Next, tie the ropes to the other mount, and using the second ratchet strap, get the ropes as tight as possible without breaking. This will take some finagling for sure, and is definitely a 2-person job. Mount your camera and you're ready to go.
From the director of Steve Nelson the movie comes an epic 3-minute saga through time and space. Actually, it's just about an open mic night in space.
Okay, everyone, I wanted to share a few things we learned while using this rig. 1, never let go of the camera when it's on the rig. One of those ropes can break. And let me tell you, attach your camera to this rig at your own risk. I'm serious. Don't sue me. Our rope broke once and it scared the bejesus out of me. 2. Our rig wasn't really totally balanced. If we were gonna build it again, we'd probably put some counterweights on the lighter side. 3, the two rope system that we designed is really better for slow camera moves. If you wanna get that crazy fly through the jungle look, you should probably stick to a one rope system. Maybe we'll build one in a future episode. All right, everybody, that's it for this week. Make sure and check out a Steve Nelson guest-directed test film coming out this Tuesday. And seriously, if you break your camera doing this rig, we're not gonna get you a new one.
If you ever need a really cheap dolly really fast, get a swivel chair and your tripod, put it together, and you've got a dolly that you can wheel around.